Hello and welcome to the Big Bang Theory podcast. My name's John. I'm here with my friend and colleague Dan.
Hello.
Dan, I'm wearing the flip-flops today on account of all the flip-flopping we're doing.
Yeah.
City lose 2-0.
We got a bit carried away, didn't we,
last week? We all did.
Yeah.
City lose 2-0 to Bradford City away.
A reality check for us.
Me and you?
Well, yeah, sort of.
The Taylor brothers?
Yeah. Are they brothers?
I wish they were.
Father and son.
No reality check for Bradford City, the Bantams, who carry on their fine run of form.
I actually didn't realise till sort of halfway through the game how good a run of form they were on. I was just kind of thinking, you know, we'll see them off. No problem after that. 4-0.
Well, disappointing, isn't it? I mean, it really showed how bad Plymouth were, but also...
Yeah, I think that, yeah, I was thinking that. It does really show how bad our goal were. But I think we had obviously had a better day then too.
So we travelled all the way. We didn't go, but a lot of people did go all the way to Bradford in Yorkshire.
Yeah.
Big ground.
I don't get to go to many away games, honestly. We'll try and get to a few, won't we? But like, on the one hand, I'd love to go to that stadium. It looks amazing. It looks so cool. I mean, apart from that, it doesn't look like there's any standing.
No.
That's sort of like right on my street, that kind of thing. Well, massive, old kind of, you know... Don't know.
So much history, of course, because it burnt down, didn't it?
Well, yeah.
And people died in that fire.
Yeah, horrific.
Rebuilt it.
It looks great, but by all accounts, Bradford's, you know, as a place, not really up to much.
Hmm.
Especially if you're from here.
Anyway,
sometimes
we didn't go.
Spoiled. Yeah.
So, but people did go, and for their reward, they got a very poor first half.
Yeah. Well, it seems like what they got was Exeter City playing some... You know, and this has been quoted a few times, really nice football.
Yep.
But without getting anything from it.
Yep. And in reverse, getting two goals up the jacksie.
Yeah, and both pretty calamitous goals too.
Very poor defending,
so
it
doesn't matter how much you're going to sort of like knock it about in midfield and, you know, be one-touch passing. If you're going to like do that sort of like comedy Chuckle Brothers... defending, I'm talking to you, Aaron Martin and Tom Parks, and to a lesser extent Johnny Maxted. He's like the third Chuckle Brother, you know, he's in a couple of episodes.
Yeah. My mate's mum's cousin is married to the third Chuckle Brother.
Wow,
that's true.
He doesn't get any cash, does he, from any of it?
He's not done any work, has he?
Well, true. No, isn't he? He's in it a bit anyway. We always end up talking about the Chuckle Brothers. But yeah, bad. Yeah, so the first one was the cross, wasn't it?
Yep.
So it's a big looping cross. It's like, it's one of those ones that's quite dangerous because it's going exactly into the right place, like right at the back post. But also, it was too kind of, for my money, it was too looping.
Well,
to have caused us that much trouble, as in, I'm not sure. It looks like Maxted could have come and got that.
And then it just bounced off Sweeney and trickled over the line.
Yeah, but also he should have been sort of doing something a bit more about it than that.
Sweens.
But I mean, first line, yeah, I think probably Maxted should probably do something with it.
It's that primary school kind of football, isn't it? Where you slightly raise your thigh. You don't know what else to do.
Yeah, yeah. It's very primary school, yeah.
It really was primary school. So that put us 1-0 down, bad start. Then a long ball from, well, their defence, really, which I think it was Martin just made an absolute mush of.
And I think initially it's Parks who misses it. Then... Martin.
Yeah.
Then they don't know who's getting it, and Park seems like he's sort of leaving it for Maxted. Maxted doesn't know who's having it either, and in it somehow, there's like one Bradford City forward gets in there, the only one who actually wants to actually kick the ball.
Yeah.
And just sort of tucks it in.
I know, it really was a bit...
That was stupid, that one. It looks... I mean, the more you watch it back, the madder it looks.
It really was a poor one. So, I mean, that's a weird switch, isn't it? We've gone from really good defence to...
Yeah, well, we've
no
one
scoring,
well,
but okay defence.
It looked more like the Argyle thing was a bit of a blip for that because, I mean, we didn't have to do much defending. But in the last three away games, it's been our kind of undoing, hasn't it?
It has.
We've let in 9 goals in the last 3 away games.
Oh, that's bad.
And scored 1.
That's bad. So, yeah, it was James Vaughan, wasn't it, who's kind of got enough about him. Like, he didn't look like he was going to do much else.
You didn't need a huge amount about you.
No, you didn't, but he stood in the right
place.
But
yeah, he did.
And I was just thinking, well, if we get to half-time, 1-0 down, that's okay, that's redeemable. Nope, 2-0 down, half-time, bad half.
Yeah.
Then we kind of look like we're pushing a bit, and then...
Well, again, I think we come out and we're playing... Yeah, we're pushing them, aren't we? And we're playing nice football.
And then Jake Taylor, a couple of days late on Halloween... pretends to be some sort of mad axe man.
Yeah, horror. I mean, it's bad, that was not.
Well, it was just ridiculous. Like,
2-footer.
Matey went flying.
Ages late, yeah. I mean, yeah, sent off. You didn't see Jake Taylor complaining, really, did you? And he's kind of, you know, I'm surprised it's his first, not his first red, but he commits a lot of fouls, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Sometimes deliberately. Yeah. Like those important ones you have to do, and he quite often gets booked.
And sometimes he throws in a kind of what you needed on that occasion, throws in a heavy tackle to get the team up for it, get the support going.
Yeah, totally.
But he was a half a second late.
Yeah, and it's going to happen, isn't it?
Matey's leg's still on its way into orbit, I believe, from that horrible tackle. But there we are. Taylor.
Yeah. Well, I don't think it was too... It wasn't like one of those dangerous ones. There's no studs up.
No, but he did an absolute flip, didn't he? The guy that got tackled.
Oh, yeah, yeah. He cleaned him out. But
yeah.
Yeah.
So that was that. 10 men. Well, fortunately, we were saved in a way because 2 minutes later, they had a fella sent off for a second yellow.
Yep. Again, yeah, standard.
Standard.
Total yellow card.
And then, of course, we really went for it. I mean...
But at that point, I'm not... Even though it's levelled out, that doesn't kind of fill me with any kind of confidence. I'm thinking 2-0 down and both teams have got a player less than they should have each. This is not, you know, this is not going according to plan.
No, it's not going to be a textbook game of football from then on, is it?
No. Kind of things went on. We
didn't
really have that huge amount of chances, did we? Did we have a couple?
Well, when you look at the statistics...
Woodman and Sweeney seem to be ones who have most of our chances.
The chances of falling to the fullbacks, which is weird in itself, although I guess that could work in a way, but we had 15 shots and one on target, which was Sweeney's that was cleaned off the line. One off target.
That's mad. That's mental.
And we had 66% possession.
Yeah.
So... Come on. I mean, come on. Now, Law had a few, like, edge-of-the-box ones.
There's one where he sort of just kind of air shot, wasn't
there? And then there was quite a good one that went over the bar. But still, how are we not, with 66% of the charges and with 15 shots...
Even getting a shot on target, even.
One on target. And so, I mean, in fairness to Sweeney, he didn't do anything wrong with his shot that was on target. They had two men on the line. The keeper made a good save.
But yeah.
14 other shots... None of which are on target, with 66% possession.
No, I mean, and you can. There's all sorts of people. You can. The finger's going to get pointed at Martin and Bowman, isn't it?
Yep.
Because they are the front two, and yeah, they've got to take some responsibility for not being able to carve out some chances for themselves. But also, the service to them wasn't good enough.
No.
So they've got to take some of the responsibility too.
Absolutely.
From what I saw, it looked like Williams perhaps was trying to get some kind of some balls into them, but they weren't making most of them. I don't know. Yeah, we're just not. Yeah, it's not what you want, is it?
I'm not going to say I'm not saying a mad thing here, and I think most people would agree with me. And I know after Taylor went off with half an hour left, it was probably not going to happen. But why isn't Matt Jay coming on as a sub at least?
Yeah, that is strange, isn't it?
Because it's bizarre.
Because he does seem to want to kind of move towards the goal at least, doesn't he? When he does come on, and everything he does is kind of like, I'll try and look for a shot or look for a kind of like a through ball or something, or like a, you know.
And he gets goals out of nothing.
Yeah, I don't know what it is. Maybe it's something in. Training that's, I don't know, that's keeping him out of that.
Or is it Taylor's system that he doesn't think suits him or something? But you know.
There's the option now, isn't there? So Jake Taylor's suspended.
Yep.
And does that mean he just misses the Cambridge Cup game?
I think straight red means 2 games suspended, doesn't it? I don't actually know. I should look this up in advance.
I think it's only one, isn't it? I don't actually know. I don't know. So anyway, that's not the point I was going to make. But what I was going to say is that surely is not. It's an opportunity for somebody to come in. Is it possible that Matt Jay can?
Well, I would think
come in that somehow. I'm not saying he's going to come in for Taylor in Taylor's position. You'd think probably be Atangana or somebody, but I don't know.
No,
there's someone needs to come in. Someone needs to shift around. So maybe there's a place for Jay to come in. I don't know if maybe Lee Martin, as hard as he works and as useful as I think he is,
yes,
maybe someone else should be given a go. I know that would be a Jose by now, obviously, if he's fit, and I think he's not too far away. But in the absence of him, maybe just find a way of getting Jay into the team, even if it's just for, 30 minutes at the end of a game or something. I mean, what can go wrong? We're already shipping a load of goals, so from a defensive point of view, it doesn't make any sense to not put him in. If you think, oh, he can't do the defending, as well, when the team's not defending well anyway, we're also not scoring goals, and that's the one thing he's shown when he does come in that he can do.
Yes.
So
absolutely.
I don't really get it, but...
And we're not the only ones. We're not the only ones, are we? They don't really get it. In terms of Taylor, it depends if they deem it to be a violent or dangerous tackle, because that could be a 3-game ban.
Well, it won't be that.
So it'll probably be one.
Also, I've just remembered this morning, we're appealing the Tom Parks one.
Yes, and I think that's legitimate. So if you haven't seen it yet, listeners, Parks, James Vaughan, this, old Everton striker... It's not like he's through on goal. It's that him and Parks are heading towards goal, both at a fairly slovenly pace. Parks gets in front of him, and in doing so, once he's in front of him, Vaughan goes over. So it's not like, in a sense, a normal last man through on goal. Parks was the last man. He was, but Vaughan wasn't racing away. Essentially, it was a normal tackle towards goal, which they happened to be both closest to. So... I think the red card shouldn't stand. I think it was a yellow, probably.
I'm not quite sure. I don't know. I know they're a bit unsure about this last man.
They've always been a bit unsure about it.
Yeah. So who knows? We'll see what happens with that. It's definitely a bit. It's a bit harsh, isn't it? But at the end of the day, apart from the suspension, it didn't make any difference to the game.
No.
And to be honest, Tom Parks hadn't exactly covered himself in glory anyway.
No.
Although in the previous game, I'm not that's being a bit harsh perhaps, because he scored in the Argyle game and they kept a clean sheet and whatnot. So I'm not having a go. I'm not saying he should be dropped anyway. All I'm saying is it's not like he was like, oh, we really need him. Moxie can come in, can't he?
No. And then Moxie, of course. I'll say this. Someone was all on Facebook in advance of the game saying, why isn't Moxie playing? I was like... Did you see the Argyle game that
it turns out
they were right.
Yeah.
So I was bad mouthing them in advance. Now I am butch.
Yeah. Well, yeah. I don't know.
All
I
apologies.
Mean, we know what it's like with that backline, don't we? Like, they're all capable of brilliant performances on their day, and they're all capable of these mad errors that lead to goals. And I suppose that's just the way it is. But
indeed, so. So that unfortunately makes the Argyle game look like a blip. Whereas we were hoping it was a turning point.
Yeah.
I guess in the grand scheme of things, of course, Bradford are really in form. They're a really big club. They've got some excellent players. Hopefully, we can forget about the way we played and just think the result was what it was. Everyone's crying out for a Jose, aren't they? And I've got no idea when we're going to see him next. But
well, I know, but... is he the...
Well, he wasn't much before he went injured,
was he?
When
he's not the answer... Which is a possibility. Then what? And he probably is, and he would have helped at some point in this little patch. But yeah, I don't think he was. It's not like he was like we gave him loads of time and it really wasn't working. He played a couple of games in a kind of slightly tweaked system, didn't really work out. But he just signed for us, and he hadn't played for. I don't know. It's not like he was given the a good run in the team and didn't cut it. It's like, but yeah, we need to have options and
yeah.
And if Matt Jay apparently isn't one, then we need to get a Jose back and at least kind of like in the running for a Martin or Bowman's place. I'm just saying, we don't have to play. Bowman doesn't have to play every minute of every game.
No, and we haven't yet seen Fisher enough, I don't think.
Yeah, well, that's quite clearly, there must be a reason behind that as well.
Of course, we don't really know because the sending off kind of changed everything. There was still half an hour left when Taylor went off.
But this is a bit of a kind of... It seems like a bit of a trait of Matt Taylor, isn't it? We saw it last season with Aaron Martin, where it looks like he just doesn't fancy somebody.
Mm.
And yet, all the supporters, I mean, what do we know? He's the professional, but you kind of think, well, everything we've seen of this guy, he looks good, or at least looks like maybe he's worth a chance if this plan isn't working.
Yes.
And yet, when Bowman's sort of... And he's been good this season, and he does a job, even if he's not scoring, and it's valuable for the team. But not even 10 minutes for Fisher when we need a goal or something. There must be something there. Yeah. It was just, like I was saying, it's the same with Aaron Martin last season. We seem to be like, you know, at times, kind of our centre backs were going off the boil, and he couldn't get back in the team. People were wondering why that was, even to the point where it looked like he was going to go in the summer. There's definitely talk of it.
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe Fisher's done something wrong.
Yeah, plenty more fishes in the sea.
Is there though?
Yes.
What you mean? Other options? I don't think there is.
No, I don't know. I think he's going to have to do something drastic. Actually, I'm coming round to the idea that he's going to need a change of a third formation that we haven't seen yet, just to shake things up a bit. And it'd be interesting to see how he approaches this cup game.
Well, here's the thing: if we're gonna be praised by, you know, whoever, people at Bradford and whatnot, as this really nice, free flowing attacking footballing team, is it absolutely essential that we have a big man to lump it to if he's not scoring goals? Like, you know, like if we're going to be like one of these teams where we're playing the ball on the floor and not whipping in crosses and long balls, then why do we need to have Bowman in there every time? Why can't we have two little men? Why can't I'm not a manager, but you know, I'm just saying there are other options.
If you play on the kind of Bowman up top system, the variety seems to be, because at the moment they play Martin kind of off him, Lee Martin.
Yeah.
Why not have the kind of false nine system and have no front man and play a really full midfield? Bowman being part of that, because he is really good at holding up and he does run really well. Given that the lumping up thing doesn't work, we're no good at corners, etc., etc.
The lumping up thing does work sometimes, that's the thing.
I just think there's scope for...
That's how we scored a non-lumpy goal in the Argyle game, though, isn't it, you know?
Yes.
It's a long ball to Bowman.
Yeah.
And it works down from that. So I understand why that works. It's not just hoofing it and hoping he headers it into the goal. It's, you know, there's more to it than that.
But I think he could... If he's the linchpin in the team, if Taylor sees his running and he's holding up play as really a big part of what we do, which I guess he does, Taylor sees that as a big part, then maybe Martin is next to him isn't the thing. Maybe there are other options around filling the midfield a bit more. You know, he's keen to bring on like Richardson. We haven't seen Williams on a more inside role or Richardson on a more inside role. We haven't seen Law on the inside right with Williams further outside. You know, I just think there's scope. Jay as a central focal attacking midfielder with Law a bit drop. You know,
we'll see. I suppose what you would say in certain things, we are slightly pinned into the fact that it's clear that Nicky Law is most effective when he's played in the middle. But a lot of last season and some of this season, when he's been moved out wide, he's been very ineffective and hasn't been able to have an influence on games. And we know that we're at our best when he's on his game. But yeah, there's got to be, you know, I think it's got to be time to look at something. I mean, it's not like we're bottom of the league and like,
no.
But our waveform is a cause for concern.
It is. And you know, the next away game's Crawley, I think, and they're not a bad team. We just don't want
to... There's not really any easy away games, is there?
No.
If your waveform is bad, and especially if it gets into a bit of a habit, then there's not going to be any kind of let up.
No, there's not. Right. Well, with that in mind, I guess we'll think about the upcoming games. So, as if our away supporters hadn't suffered enough, they got to go back to the scene of the crime, Cambridge United. They don't have to, but they will, because they're excellent. And, you know, they know that I'm going to take all my hats off to them. Back to Cambridge United for the first round of the FA Cup.
Yeah.
So three weeks ago, we went there.
Yeah.
Beaten 4-0.
This is going to be the interesting... No, they beat us 4-0.
Sorry, they beat us 4-0, yeah.
This is going to be interesting in terms of the team that plays, isn't it?
Yeah, it really is.
It's an opportunity to... No, he's got to go. He's got to try and win this one, hasn't he? It's not like you wouldn't think this is going to be a kind of... I'm not saying he would ever throw it, but he's not going to put out a kind of deliberately weak team to concentrate on the league kind of job. Has he got to go for this?
I would think so, absolutely. And we've got... The games for now are Saturday. Yeah, I know we've got the old
exactly.
lease in.
So it's not like
up.
We've got anything like, yeah.
There's no Tuesday coming up after.
No.
So I think he's got to go for it. I mean, I don't think it can... Well, he said optimistically. I don't think it can be as bad as a 4-0 away again.
But
you never know.
You never know.
The variety of things that could happen are Moxie comes back in. I think that's quite likely. I think we could see Atangana in some way, obviously with the Taylor suspension.
I think that's likely, yeah.
Sparks and Collins in some way. Obviously, he's using Richardson sporadically. Mm. There's scope for these things, as we've just said. Fisher, Jay. I think Jay's got to be...
I'll tell you this, there's no chance that Bowman's not starting. 100%.
You reckon?
Bowman will start,
I think
yeah.
you're probably
And
right.
probably play the 90.
Yeah. I'd love to see Jay. I'd love to see Jay get a proper chance. Not just this week.
Yeah, but that's the thing, is if he plays this week, it's almost like, oh, he's given him his go here. So, and then he won't in the league, you know? Like,
that does seem to be the system.
I don't get it, but I'm not pinning everything on Matt Jay as if he's kind of the best player ever. He obviously, you know, Taylor and the coach and staff know a lot more than I do. But it, on a very basic level, I'd like to... I don't know.
Well, he's boundless.
I'd like to know why.
He's boundless in his energy. He
yeah,
does
and
get
apparently
goals.
That's all you need to stay in this team. You know, Lee Martin, but Ryan Bowman, I'm talking to you.
Yeah, but he's had results. He's had success, old Jay, hasn't he? And I think we've kept him around. Like, we didn't have to keep him around. It's not like, you know, there are lots of equivalents of Jay who've gone out on loan a lot or gone, been sold or just been let go.
I think he's made it very difficult for Exeter City to let go of him by his performances starting last year when he came in and really let us off the hook a couple of times.
Absolutely.
With like finally scoring some goals and like
important
really
goals.
Yeah, important goals, and really kind of like stamping his kind of mark on games and like just think and being like, yeah, I can step in and do this. And he doesn't seem bothered that he, you know,
because
he's still putting in these performances. Like, he's still like trying to take his chances, but I don't know, you think like someone like Jack Sparks comes on and plays well for 20 minutes and then gets a run in the team for a couple of months.
Yeah.
Matt Jay can't seem to, you know, and Ben Seymour's had, and I'm not taking anything away from Seymour. Last season he was like banging him in one for the under 23s or whatever it was, or reserves, yeah. And deserves his chance and has had plenty of chances. He comes on most games, you know, doesn't he? Towards
he does.
The end of the game. But
yeah.
But Jay, hardly ever.
I know. Curious. I'd like to see him.
And Seymour, to me, looks like, you know, a long way from the finished article, whereas Matt Jay looks like a competent professional footballer. I don't know. It's strange. Maybe I'm wrong.
I do think we could really do with a result at Cambridge, though, or just something to cling on to.
Yeah, like, well, I think...
I think we'd take it. If we lost 4-3, I think we'd take it.
I think another bad loss is just going to just compound this kind of feeling that's definitely like, you know...
Yeah, oh, what are we going to do?
I know the Argyle game lifted everyone's spirits. I'm sure it lifted the team's spirits, definitely the fans and, well, us, you know. But just, I don't know, it's not enough, is it, when you follow it up with something like that?
No. Because the defence was so calamitous... Oh, I can't speak. Because the defence was so calamitous... You wonder what the instruction is there, because sure, a place like Bradford, who we know are in form, and it's a great big, I mean, it was a Premier League stadium 10 years ago. It's a formidable place. There were a lot of supporters there, blah, blah, blah. You'd think that given that we're an away team out of form and given that we're a team that haven't got a bag full of goals, you'd think the advice would be keep it tight for as long as possible.
Yeah, well, that definitely wasn't that. In fact, we were praised by Bradford fans specifically for not doing that.
Yeah. And I think that's strange choice.
Yeah.
I mean, I know if we'd gone and won it 3-2, like we'd all be saying, who cares? We like the free-flowing football.
And you can kind of forgive him off the back of the Argyle performance.
You kind of can.
But still, yeah, there's enough subtext there in there to think maybe we should just try and keep it tight. Because we've got to be careful. We are capable of that. Think back to the beginning of the season. We were winning 1-0, grinding out these results, weren't we? You know, or drawing very low scoring draws.
Yeah.
So that team is capable of that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know.
I mean, we definitely miss Lewis Ward. I think we can say that.
I mean, I don't want to.
No, you don't want to pull up Maxted because he's been a better reserve than anything we've had in a long time.
Yeah, and, you know, he's not had much of a chance, really, to prove himself. It's only a handful of games, isn't it?
Yeah.
He does seem to be a bit up and down. Although there were a couple of good saves on Saturday as well.
Yeah.
It could have been a lot worse. But like I said, he could have done a bit better, I think, in both. A commanding presence in both of those two goals is what you need. And I don't know, he seems like he's got the air of that. He doesn't seem like a nervous kind of type, does he? You know, like.
No.
In fact, if anything, you'd think in a fight, he'd beat Lewis Ward, wouldn't he? You'd think.
Alas, this isn't boxing, this is football.
And you think he'd be like louder and. I don't know, I'm just projecting onto these two people. But I don't know. Yeah, we do miss him.
Do miss him. So that's what's happening next, Cambridge.
One
away.
Quick note on that last game. So, did you listen to it on the radio?
Yeah.
Why is he keep calling him? Who was it? What's this guy's name again?
I don't know.
Seabridge. Seabrook.
Right.
I don't know the commentator's name.
Yeah.
He kept calling him Laws.
Yeah.
To the point where I had to look it up to see if Bradford had a player called Laws. And I was just like getting confused. But no. I mean, if I was Alan Tong, and I think he's brilliant, you know, he's really good on the co-commentary. I would just write it on a little bit of paper and just sort of slip it into his eye line and being like, Law, underline, 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 and then an S and cross it out, you know? Like, it's,
tell him at half time. There's no telling these people. That guy definitely thought he knew
it. What
do
you mean? He's a commentator.
No, I mean, but he's obviously taken up. He's obviously got the arrogance of a person who thinks he knows things. You know that kind of person?
I mean, this is big talk, isn't it, for a couple of people who just took it upon themselves to talk, start an Exeter City podcast. Which also kind of, on that note, I realised the irony of me saying Ryan Lowe loved the sound of his own voice last week. Anyway. Okay, that was it.
That's fair.
Other than that, great commentary.
Would you, if we were offered a position as commentators for one game, would you take it?
Yeah, give it a go.
What would you be, the commentator or the
I think
summariser?
I'm quite naturally the co-com, aren't I?
Are you? So I'm
our friend James Harris did it.
He did.
And he did a brilliant job.
He did, at Stevenage away.
Yes. Yeah, Stevenage away. Yeah.
Out of nowhere.
Did it brilliantly.
Good job, Harris.
Although, I was kind of expecting a shout-out.
So was I.
And there wasn't one, and so I don't really know why we were giving him one now. So.
If I was there now, I'd be writing it on a bit of paper, Big Bang Theory podcast, and underlining it and tapping it.
Yeah.
Saying, say the name of the podcast. I'm interested to know who listens to this podcast. We're just surmising here. We've always wondered whether players do, and we think they probably don't. They've got more sense. Do the Echo listen?
I don't know.
I'm doing a knowing face at you. I think they do.
Right. Okay, maybe.
Who else? I think we're the go-to for City knowledge.
But we're the only Exeter City podcast.
But so we're often...
We're definitely the go-to Exeter City podcast.
We're definitely that.
We're the only active Exeter City podcast.
Was there was one in the past, wasn't
I think
there?
There's been a couple before.
Grecian Chat. Is that what it's called?
I don't know. I think there's been a couple, but anyway, we're the only currently active one. So if you... Yeah.
We just were interested to know. And do you think people who want to know about League Two are listening to us? I think not.
No.
They should be.
You reckon?
Yeah.
Well, this is through a very Exeter City lens.
Yeah,
but
if they want to know about Exeter City, they should be tuning in.
Yeah, if you want to know about Exeter City, but we want about League Two.
Well, Exeter City are in League Two.
Yeah, but there's other kind of... We're not covering anything else in League Two. Sorry.
Well, no, we're not, but we are going to cover something in League One in a minute.
Oh, are we?
Are we, Begora?
I think we should.
So, listeners, if you've had your head under a rock, that's not a phrase, if you've had your head in the sand or you've been living under a rock, you might not know that Exeter City used to have a manager called Paul Tisdale.
Yeah, for what, 12 years, was it?
Very long time. And he left our football club some 18 months previous. Matt Taylor replaced him. And Tisdale went to in essence, a football club, but really it's just a bunch of jokers in a car park who've got their own stadium, called Milton
Keynes. It's a challenge on The Apprentice, essentially, isn't it?
Basically, a challenge on The Apprentice, except The Apprentice would deem this too unlikely a storyline. and no one would ever believe it, which is that they nicked a club from somewhere in London, set it up in Milton Keynes, which of course is a made-up, fantastical place, and started their own club, MK Dons. Tisdale, in an absolute irony overload, after leaving us, went to MK Dons, of course he did, and has slowly been ruining their chances of staying in League One this year.
Well, he also put them into League One.
Well, they put themselves into League One, and he was also there.
At first attempt. Yeah, you know what? It is funny in a way, isn't it?
Yeah.
But, you know, I know we've given him a lot of stick, and I'm quite happy to carry on doing that, but we are children of Paul Tisdale.
Yeah, we are.
You know, as in almost literally he was there long enough for us to go from, you know, boys to men under his tutelage.
What, the male vocal harmony group from Los Angeles,
no,
Boys
no,
to Men?
No, with S's, not Z's.
Oh, okay.
And, you know,
we loved him. We loved him at the time.
We,
at certain points, we loved
you
him.
And I especially, sorry, loved him all the way to the end. And we didn't want him to leave, let's not forget.
No.
I definitely didn't.
I didn't he want did. Him to leave until he left. And then I was like...
Yeah, and you know... I think it's the right decision in the end. It seems to be anyway. And yeah, he's gone now from MK Dons because they were doing absolutely terribly in League Two. I think they'd lost 8 out of their last 9.
Yeah, and only scored 1 goal.
Yeah, which is
That's spectacular.
Yeah, it's really bad. And so he's...
On the market.
He's on the market.
So we've had a message.
And we are floundering. So...
Someone sent us a message on Twitter,
one
was it?
One plus one equals...
The question on Facebook or Twitter was, would we take him back?
I think it's more sort of, isn't it, would you take him back, and then it means we definitely get promoted, and then he goes again.
Wow, that's very specific.
That was the actual sort of fantasy scenario.
Let's unpack that.
Okay.
All right, so if the situation is as it is now... Would I want Matt Taylor sacked?
It definitely means Matt Taylor has to go.
Okay, so Matt Taylor's...
That's the jeopardy of the question.
Oh, good Lord. I'm not ready for this kind of emotional roller coaster. So Taylor gets sacked now.
Yeah.
Tisdale comes in.
Yep.
Smug.
Yeah, and we get promotion.
And we get promotion.
Yeah. Then he leaves.
Then he leaves. And does he then go to, like, Argyle or...
That's...
Or they move Manchester City to Dublin, and he's then in charge of Dublin City. And
that's not our concern afterwards.
Well, it would be.
That's the question. We're now in League Two. No, sorry, we're promoted
to
League One, and we are managerless.
So Taylor ain't coming back, presumably.
Well, you'd imagine he wouldn't want to.
Imagine he wouldn't want to.
We then have to look. The obvious answer to this, it's a very easy answer. No, is
no.
The answer to that question.
Okay.
No, I don't want that.
Okay.
But, you know...
All right, let's...
Some people might, because, you know, it's the one thing we really... We do want to get that promotion, don't we? It's been this kind of, like, monkey on our back pretty much since we've come back down from League One.
Yeah.
Just to get back up there.
And we've been good enough some seasons to go back up. And,
yes, absolutely.
And we ballsed it up, thanks in some parts to Tisdale.
Yeah.
Particularly the Wembley appearances both times.
Yeah. Although, you know, as much as he's got to take the credit for... not getting us through the final. He also has to take the credit for getting us there.
Yeah, okay.
Anyway.
I mean, so. I think there's not really any talk yet of Taylor going or people wanting him to go. No. I think people are like, oh, this could be better. And I think people are a bit like, sort it out, Taylor.
We're nowhere near that.
We're
still in the
that.
Promotion. We're still in the playoff places.
We're very much in the playoff places.
Well, and I mean, there's just quite a few teams with a couple of games in hand over us,
no,
I think.
No, even so.
Even so.
Even so.
Okay,
the teams outside the playoffs are on the same games as us.
Okay.
So the teams...
So we're doing pretty well. Well, we're doing about as well as we were last year.
Yeah, which is fine currently.
Yeah. We've got to be careful to not have these kind of like reactionary responses to... And
we've never been, well, we
haven't
been that kind of club.
It's what modern football's like nowadays.
Yeah.
You know, like, but he's a new manager. It's going to take him a while. We can't expect to get promoted even necessarily in the first 2 seasons of him starting this job.
No, indeed.
It's unrealistic. He's learning his trade, you know. He's learning how to do it. And if he does, he'll have seriously overachieved.
Yeah, absolutely. And let's be very, very honest. Our club is sustainable because... we get managers we can afford, and we sell players as soon as they're any good.
Yes.
So if we're lucky, when we get promoted, whenever that will be next, whether it's this season or next, it means that...
Or the one after.
Maybe the one after. That the good enough players are with us for long enough to be able to influence the points tally enough to get us to the next league.
Yeah.
That's what happens, isn't it? And so Stockley, if we'd held on to him for another 5 months, promotion almost certainly, or we would have had a much better chance of promotion last year. Same set of Grimes.
Yeah, say, the fact we weren't in a position to keep hold of him.
No.
So therefore, we weren't in a position to go up.
No, that's
so
right.
That's just how it is.
That's just how it is. And yeah, we could bring in, I don't know who. I mean, there's no one guaranteed promotion. But, you know, Danny Cowley. Okay, let's say we could get Danny Cowley in. Well, the money it would cost us would be so extortionate.
It was nowhere to be worth it, was there? You know.
So, I mean, I'm well up for sticking for Taylor.
I don't even care. I like being in League Two.
I wouldn't. I wouldn't like Tisdale back. I think.
Nah,
right time for him
he
to go.
Come
and
back.
Let's not forget how much it divided the fans.
Exactly.
It was horrible.
You'd never get away with it. You couldn't come back now.
No.
People hate him.
Yeah. Well, people hate him. And even the people that like him, and
I think people have hated him more than when he was...
The people
that don't like him probably hate him even more now. And if he came back, it would be... They would stop coming, you know? There's people that would stop coming.
And just the atmosphere would be...
And especially as it's like, not only is he coming back, but presumably we've sacked Matt Taylor to make this happen.
Who we all really like.
Who everyone really likes, and... Yeah.
Okay. So cancel the taxi for Tisdale.
Yeah.
On that note...
Sorry, Ryan. You're not coming either.
That's... I mean, yeah. What's going to happen to Harley and Simpson and that?
Well, Simpson's already left.
Oh, of course he has. Yeah, yeah.
What's going to happen to Daff? Daff. What's his name?
What is his name?
You know, that guy... I can't remember his name. Maybe he's already gone. Lawson Daff.
Oh, right. I don't know. I think MK...
What a weird name. Anyway,
they'll be lucky to stay up because it's been terrible for them.
Well,
they've got no supporters.
Their new manager is one of their players.
Oh, is it?
Russell something or something Russell.
Oh, right.
Yeah. So okay. They've obviously had to go for the cheap option because it's
pay off.
Cost them a lot of money to get rid of Tisdale.
And Oakley's gone and Gwinnett's gone.
And the other guy.
Yeah. That's right. So a big old clear out. On that note, you know, City, of course, excellent youth academy... Always bringing young players in. Have you been following Ben Crescens' travels around the continent?
A bit, yeah.
So it's kind of Ampadu situation again. He hasn't signed for us, is that right?
As far as I know, yeah. He's just like, yeah, he hasn't.
Plays for us, but he hasn't got the professional contract. His Instagram stories tell me that in the last fortnight, he's been training with Bayern Munich and with Aston Villa.
Yeah, and we know he was asked to come to Chelsea for a look around or something, wasn't he? Or a day out.
So
he's going, isn't
he? He's
going somewhere.
He's going somewhere. It's how long we can cling on to him for. But, of course, they'll want him in their academy pretty quickly.
Yeah, and we all get no money for that, nothing. Bit of spare change.
Well, he's played one game, right?
No, a couple. Played a couple.
Okay, so we'll get a few hundred thousand, I'd imagine.
Yeah, maybe.
Maybe.
Ampadu played, like, 11 games.
Yeah, but how much did we get for him? Million and a half, was it?
Was it?
Was it?
We haven't got all of it yet, have we?
No. I think that's what the tribunal...
I would particularly like to. Although Ampadu did play for Leipzig the
weekend.
Oh,
he did.
Came on for his first appearance. They won 8-0. And I'm not sure what the score was when he came on.
Wow.
But, you know.
Blimey. Grimes' success is continuing.
Yeah.
He could well find himself.
I didn't see that happening.
No,
you know, it looked like the old familiar story, didn't it, of a player going off to a big team and then it's sort of not working and then them sort of dropping back down. Maybe not all the way back down, but you know.
But he's captain, and people are singing his praises.
Yeah.
So well done, Matt Grimes.
Yeah, Ollie Watkins, obviously.
Obviously, Ollie Watkins is flying.
We may still see a payday from that.
Yes, that's right. If he goes to a Premier League team, which I think is quite likely...
Yeah, you'd think.
We'll do well.
Yeah. Do we get any sort of like bonus if Preston get promoted?
I don't think so. Because Stockley started playing again. You know,
yeah,
they're top of the league. Yeah, well, it's a good time to be a former Exeter City alumni in the Championship. So that's got everyone up to speed.
Pretty much, yeah.
Thanks for getting in contact. People asking questions, people... laughing at silly jokes on Twitter. We've been the Big Bang Theory podcast. You can get in touch with us on the internet via email, bigbankpod@gmail.com, on Twitter @bigbankpod, and on Facebook, the Big Bang Theory podcast. My name's John. I've been here with my friend and colleague, Dan.
Yeah, cheers.
We still don't know the relationship between Grecian and New Grecian.
No. No, I don't think anyone does, because there isn't one.
Ah.
They're two mascots. I don't think they need a backstory. Maybe Exeter could run a competition for youngsters to come up with a plausible backstory for those two and how they know each other.
I'd like to read that. If anyone wants to write that for us, we'd be interested to see it. I've been reading...
I feel like I'm coming up with a lot of ideas here for Exeter City. They're not, one, they're not taking any of them.
No.
Which leads me to think that no one is listening to this. But also, because they are genuinely good ideas. But, you know...
Yeah, it can't
also
be the ideas that are the problem.
Like that... Do you remember ages ago I talked about the Plymouth Argyle smashing arena?
Yes.
Didn't happen. Disappointing, that. I thought that's a really good idea.
Anyway. Oh, well. Maybe they'll take up the idea of the backstory of the Lions. In the meantime, I've been reading a new book. It's called The Story of Exeter's St. James Park, Land of Grecian Glory. It's a new book. The Trust have put some money in, and this guy, Aidan Hamilton's written it, who wrote the play about when we played Brazil.
Okay.
It's really interesting. I'd recommend it to anyone out there interested in the history of St. James Park. I'm not going to give it away now, but way weirder a history than I thought it was.
Oh, I've got to read that.
Yeah.
Sounds great.
I totally recommend it. Don't forget, it's the Trust elections this week, and the AGM coming up, I think, the same day as Cheltenham at home.
So you've got to get... I think there's 2 weeks in there to get the
I think you've got to vote
in
this week. I think the deadline's this week for voting.
Is that right?
And then it'll be announced at the AGM.
You can read all the... if you're a Trust member, you would have been sent it in the post, all their kind of manifestos, but you can read them all online if you're a member and care. I think it's really good that there's that many people that... standing for it, and
absolutely,
they want to be a part of it. It shows that it's, you know, a real gun of going concern, doesn't it? And it's that it's still sort of working after all this time.
Yeah,
you know?
Absolutely.
And it hasn't become, you know.
No, it hasn't at all. So fair play to anyone who's standing in that election. And even if you don't get voted in, I hope you realise we appreciate your willingness to do that.
Oh, totally, yeah.
Right, well, thanks for listening. We'll see you next week. Take it easy.
See you later.